Hey everybody, I'm looking at another cool little planetary nebula. This one is known as NGC 2438, and this is Elite Dangerous. This is another real planetary nebula, but this is Elite's version of it. As far as I can tell, it doesn't actually have a name, and yeah, it's around the star BD-14, 2129. One jump out now, 17.1 light years away. It's about 3,000 light years from Earth, near the Seagull Nebula, which is probably where I'll go next. Where's Earth? There we go. Earth is over there. So zoom out some. There you go. That gives you an idea. Yep, 3184 light years away, so about 3200 light years. So, nice pretty blue one. Let's go back to that. I don't know if there's a closer one to this one. I think that star's a little closer. But I'll just go jump right in now. Take a look. I've been doing a lot of exploration, looking at planetary nebula. They're kind of pretty. There's a bunch of them. I'm also looking at normal nebula, like the big nebula. Like this, I said, the Seagull Nebula, I'll probably check out next. Here we go. Dump a heatsink. I'm running low on heatsinks. Nice. This pretty blue nebula. There we go. It does look good. Yeah. I'm liking that. There you go. Get the screenshot there. So there you go. I love the looks of these sort of planetary nebulas. So did we actually have anything? I already forgot what this game was. There you go. A rescan. Oh, just the star. Well, you know. Maybe there's a signal. Nope. I can sort of make out over there Bernard's loop. So that's the galactic plane. So it's actually this way. Earth's that away. Ish. 3,000 light years. Nice blue everywhere. There's Andromeda Galaxy. That's probably the Seagull Nebula, if I were to guess. I don't know what this one is over there. Yeah, let's see what the closest star is. That one. Let's go there.
Frameshift drive charging.
This is as good a view as you can get from the outside. and stuff on the inside. Now, blue's my favorite color, so this one's a nice one to me. It's a shame we don't have, like, a lot more nebula stuff happening near Earth. For real. That would be the main thing I think I'd want to do in real space, if that ever happens before I'm old and die. Look at Nebula, which is pretty.
Fuel scooping. Fuel scooping complete.
12 bodies. What do we have? Looks like they've all been mapped. One of them's, it's either oceanic or an Earth-like. I think it's oceanic. But first, I'm gonna... select this guy so I can figure out where I'm going. So I want to see. Oh, there it is. Well, that looks about the same as the other place. Let's do this. And then. Yeah, and then. Here we go. Something like that. Get rid of it. Orbit lines. I don't know if I can get rid of orbit lines. I can zoom in though, right? There we go. Okay. So, there you go. BD-14. 2129, the planetary nebula NGC 2438, nice pretty blue planetary nebula. While I'm here, let's take a look around. One of these was an oceanic world, probably. This one. Let's take a look at that. Come on. No, no. It's not letting me. Eh. I'm just gonna do this. Yeah, it's a water world. And it is that one. I like the water worlds too, and of course Earth lights are nice. Let's take a quick look. So I would imagine the surface temperature is going to be pretty low. If they're accurate with their simulation, which they seem to be vaguely accurate. So probably more like an ice ball than a water ball. And 8-7. Start pulling it down. So yeah, this is the closest star to that nebula. CQYD1. And the fifth planet is a water world. Let me take a look, because I like water worlds. Six probes. And go.
Surface scanned by 50%.
As close as we get. Oh, hey, there's actually a little island. So, it'd take me 4 hours to actually get to the planet. Oh well. And of course he'll hit the exclusion boundary way before. So, let's call it a day. See ya.